In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to patch Oracle Weblogic Server 12C with Opatch utility. I'm Mohammed Abdelsamia, a senior functional specialist at ITS company, and in this tutorial, you're gonna learn all you need to know about applying patches to Oracle Weblogic Server 12C on Windows Server using Opatch utility. We'll talk about Opatch utility, then preparing how to use it, and at the end, we will learn how to apply patches using the Opatch utility. So, Opatch is just a Java-based utility that's used to apply patches to Oracle software. And there are four types of patches, like interim patch, bundle patch, security patch update, and batch set updates. Now, let's prepare our environment to use Opatch. We need to complete some prerequisites to prepare our environment to run the Opatch utility. And before applying any prerequisite, we must close any running Weblogic services. First, we need to make sure that we have a compatible version of Java, as well as setting its environment variables correctly by following the next steps. To get our Java version, we will run the command prompt and type the Java version command. Then, after that, if we don't see the Java version or we have an older version of Java, we must download the compatible version then install it. After installing the Java version, we will set the Java environment variables by opening the environment variables from the advanced system settings. Then we will set the Java home, JRE home, and Java path, then restart our machine. Second prerequisite is to locate the installed Opatch utility and obtain its version by following the next steps. We will run the command prompt as administrator, then change directory to Oracle Home Opatch directory by typing this command. Then type the following two commands to locate and obtain the Opatch version. The next step in the prerequisites is to set Oracle Home environment variable and backup the Oracle Home directory by following the next steps. We will open the environment variables again and set Oracle Home path to the Oracle Home environment variable, then restart our machine. After the restart, we will backup the Oracle Home by copying it or archiving it. The last step in our prerequisites is to obtain the required patches of our installation from the Oracle support website, as well as reviewing the README file included with each patch to check the required version of Opatch. Now, after downloading the required Opatch version required for the patch, we will start installing it by following the next steps. We will run the command prompt as administrator, then setting our Java by changing the directory to WebLogic domain directory and type the following commands. Then we will type the following command to upgrade the Opatch version, and finally validate the Opatch installation by typing the following commands. The last step in our tutorial is to apply the required patch using the Opatch utility by doing several tasks. We have already made the first three tasks, so we will start with task number 4, which is applying the patch. Then verifying that the patch was applied successfully and software runs properly. If the patch is not applied successfully, we can use the Opatch rollback command to remove the patch. And before using Opatch apply command, let's check if this patch is applicable to our Oracle home or not by using one of the following commands: the Opatch check applicable command or Opatch apply report command. After checking if the patch is applicable or not, the last step is to apply the patch by following the next steps. We will first run the command prompt as administrator, then change the directory to the opatch directory, then apply the patch by typing the opatch apply command, then verifying that the patch is applied to our environment by typing the opatch ls inventory command. And finally, we will start our Weblogic server to verify that our server is running properly. That's it for this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching.